wins in Lynx history. Seattle is 10-12 and in the postseason playoff mix right now. Seattle starting five has been the same since the third game of the season. It's Sue Bird, Jewel Lloyd, Alicia Clark, Brianna Stewart, and Crystal Langhorne. Stewart and Lloyd were consecutive rookies of the year in each of the last 2 years. The Lynx have their first starting lineup change of this season. Simone Augustus is not with the team tonight for personal reasons, so Gia Perkins will start in her absence with Waylon Moore, Brunson, and Fowles. Leah, what are your keys for tonight?
All right, well, we'll kick it off with the Storm. Value the possession. They have the highest turnover percentage in the league in sharing the ball. They had 29 assists in the win against Dallas. For Minnesota, defensive intensity and attacking the basket. The Storm will struggle defending the Lynx if they're aggressive at getting to the basket.
I'm going to guess Sylvia Fowles is not going to win this tip, or I should maybe say the Lynx will not win this tip. And it goes to Seattle and Sue Bird. Minnesota's not won a tip all season long, and it is by design. Jewel Lloyd puts up the first shot of the game and misses. There's an interesting article in the Star Tribune this morning. It had never really occurred to me that Minnesota never wins the tip. 0 for 20 this season. No tips won last year. This way they get the ball to start the second and third quarter, and that's more important. So it's strategy.
Yes, and something that Coach Reeve has decided is very important to her team, and it sounds like she has a lot of other things that they wouldn't give up in the story that she likes to do as well.
Lindsey Whalen from the elbow hits the first shot of the night for Minnesota. Sue Bird with the ball, 16th season in the WNBA, gives it up to Lloyd. Off the rim for Jewel. She was the rookie of the year in 2015. Brianna Stewart was the rookie of the year last season. So it's a nice mix of youth and veterans on this Seattle team. Whalen misses that time from the left side. Alicia Clark. And now Bird. Into Brianna Stewart, and Stewart goes with the hook shot, a little short. Offensive rebound nicely, though, by Lloyd.
Something that Seattle doesn't do very often, second chance points, but Lloyd does a nice job of getting the offensive rebound.
Perkins into the starting lineup for the first time this season. Dishes to Maya from the corner, in and out. Morris really shot the ball well over the last three games at 55%. Struggled to find her range in the first month of the season. Taps that one away, but it'll stay Seattle ball. Jenny Busick is in her third season as head coach of Seattle. She's been a part of the WNBA, though, for 18 seasons, and she's just trying to get her team over that 500 mark. They've kind of hovered there all season long. They're definitely in the playoff mix, though, at 10-12. Right now, sitting ninth.
And this is a team that has such a great starting five.
Langhorne to Stewart.
You have a couple of all-stars on this team, some of the young up-and-coming players in this league, so you get the sense that when this team starts playing really well together, when they start finishing games, they're going to be something to contend with, but they're going to have to get going pretty quick here.
First foul of the night on Maya Moore. And here is Stewart. The fastest player in the WNBA ever to 1,000 points and 500 rebounds. It took her 55 games. That just happened on Friday, too.
She is something special to watch. She can do so many things with the basketball.
Stewart, the second-year player out of UConn. It's a UConn-heavy game tonight.
Aren't they all?
They tend to be. Perkins out of Texas Tech. Tamaya, UConn product, knocked away. Maya regains control. Perkins looks at the three, hits the three. Gia Perkins, who's only 23% beyond the arc, hits.
That's a big shot for Gia Perkins getting into the starting lineup. Wants to come in right away, hit a big shot for Coach Reeve.
Bird, top of the key, long three-pointer. And she nailed that one.
This is one of the things that makes Seattle difficult to guard because they hit the three ball very well.
Brunson will try to match it, and she gets it. The three balls are just raining in St. Paul.
We talk about it in each and every game, but Brunson's ability to hit that three-point shot, something she worked on in the offseason, paying off for the Lynx now.
Storm swinging all the way around. Here's Clark, puts it on the ground.
Bird off the screen back to Clark. And in the paint, she was looking for Langhorne, but did not find her. It's a turnover for Seattle. And it's really good to see Gia Perkins hit this big shot early for Minnesota. Perkins did not score Friday against Atlanta, on 0 of 3 from the floor. Nealon working her way into the paint, turns and hits. Lindsay's got a couple of baskets already here in this first quarter. Stewart and Berg back and forth. Langhorne, left-handed shot from the baseline is good. Crystal Langhorne is an impressive big player for Seattle, who doesn't have a really big like a Sylvia Fowles at 6'6". Brianna Stewart, 6'4", but she plays so much like a forward. And there goes Syl to work on those bigs of Seattle.
First time Minnesota gets to Sylvia Fowles in this game tonight. And that's something you're going to want to see him do over and over in this game, exploit the paint.
Lloyd, pounded by Brunson. Nice touch pass by Stewart to Clark, but she couldn't handle. And Moore comes away.
And the Lynx defense, something they worked on in shoot around today, really doing a nice job of switching and moving on Seattle.
Brunson with the hook, rattles in and out. Stewart grabs the rebound and pushes it up the court, crosses over into the lane. And Stewart made contact with Moore. Foul came on Moore, that is the second. So Moore has two fouls early on in that game. It looked like she was kind of the one that Stewart ran into, as opposed to Moore running into Stewart or causing the contact. Lloyd makes it hurt, though. Hits off the jumper.
Let's see how long Coach Reed leaves Maya Moore in this game. She's going to pull her out now.
And Renee Montgomery is already at the scorer's table. And there's a first foul on Brianna Stewart. Here's a look at that foul. Or a look at the Jewel Lloyd jump shot.
The young and up-and-coming stars, and I guess not really so much up-and-coming anymore. She's been, her third season has been outstanding, but getting better and better every season.
Brunson works on Langhorne off the glass and in. Rebecca Brunson, 2 for 3 with 5 points. Seattle is starting a 5-game road trip tonight. Lloyd drives, and it's another foul on Minnesota. Seattle's playing physical, getting into the bodies. Coach, along with Shelly Patterson and James Wade, Walt Hopkins, the whole coaching staff, represented coaching the West. Minnesota just had a heavy presence, and Sylvia Fowles saying that we knew Maya was going to win MVP because she said before the game she wanted to win the MVP.
Of course, you're right. Well, it looked like it was a fun time had by all, and I think that is a special event for all of those players to be involved in, and the coaches and the coaching staff to be around all the different players. So it's definitely a really exciting time for the Minnesota Lynx when you have that many representatives.
Whalen was the only starter not part of the All-Star festivities, but she got the rest. And I think at this point, that is pretty valuable. And so is the play of Sylvia Fowles. Offensive rebound up and off the glass. That's 4 straight field goals for the Lynx that have come in the paint.
And something, as we talked about at the top of the broadcast, that will be very important for them. They want to win the battle in the paint tonight.
Clark. Knocked away by Montgomery. That's something we talked about at the beginning of our broadcast, was how well Minnesota has had an advantage in the paint. Part of it is denying your opponent. Part of it is getting points like this.
Absolutely, and having Sylvia Fowles underneath at 6'6", being able to grab offensive rebounds and make easy baskets. 8 points in the paint for Minnesota as compared to Seattle's 2.
Stewart got the shot off just before the shot clock buzzer, but it was off the mark. Whalen brings it up the other way. Crosses over, picks up Langhorne, and now Clark defensively. Knocked away momentarily. Stewart got a hand on it and caused the travel on Sylvia Fowles. So Brianna Stewart, the second-year player, getting up in the grill of Sylvia Fowles.
Yeah, she wants to make Fowles put that ball on the floor just how she did right there and hopes that she'll turn it over.
Seattle substitution is Sammy Whitcomb, who is a three-point shooting specialist. Lloyd. Brunson skies for the rebound. Renee Montgomery. Foul away from the ball. And judging from the reaction, I'm going to say that's against the Storm. It is. It's Crystal Langhorne. That's her first foul tonight.
Crystal Langhorne, a player that the Lynx really have focused on in this game because of her ability to do so much down low. And she's only 6'2", but she can get a lot done.
She's a heck of a shooter, 68%. Whalen spins free. Nice move by Whalen, but could not finish. Bird dribbles around a couple of defenders. Nice lob for Stewart. They swing it around. There's Whitcomb. The ball hit a couple of Lynx hands. It ends up in the hands of Gia Perkins. Double team. She finds Fowles, but it's off her hand. So a couple of nice defensive possessions for Seattle.
Well, and both teams on the offensive end, just a little bit thrown by the defense on each side. Both teams kind of lifted the level of the defensive intensity.
Whalen checks out. Natasha Howard is in the game for Minnesota. Howard has seen a few more minutes, had a nice game in Atlanta on Friday with 11 minutes and 15 seconds. She had 8 points on 4 of 5 shooting from the field. Bird off the dribble. No call and no basket.
Sue Bird definitely wanted a basket or a call there.
She gave the officials that look, raised her arms. Brunson gets free, gets behind the defender, and lays it in off the glass. Brunson has 7 points to lead Minnesota in scoring. Stewart with the three. Fouls her third rebound.
Seattle really gone cold from outside, and that's such a huge part of their game.
1 for 5 for the Storm. Perkins, though, she hits, and Gia Perkins is 2 for 2. It's an 8-1 Minnesota run, and Jenny Busek calls a quick timeout to talk about it with her team. Suddenly, it's an 8-point Lynx lead. Rebecca Brunson was part of this surge lead.
Doing the dirty work down low. Nice basket. Two players on her, and Gia Perkins has been big in this game, coming in as a starter, hitting some nice big open shots for the Lynx.
Perkins is 2 of 2 with 5 points. And again, she started tonight for Simone Augustus, who is not with the team because of personal reasons. And the Lynx actually went on this 8-1 run, Leah, when Maya Moore sat out with her two fouls. And that would be the one thing you thought probably wouldn't happen, that the Lynx would just try to maintain, and instead they surged.
Well, I will say the one thing about this Minnesota Lynx team is that they have so many offensive weapons that when Maya Moore goes to the bench, there are so many other players that can score that ball. Now, you probably don't ever want Maya Moore on the bench for that long, but as you said, the team doesn't take a dip when she takes that seat.
And she picked up the two early fouls, and so to be able to sub her out and know that your team will be okay for a few minutes, yeah, it is a big deal. Moore didn't score. She only took one shot and played 5 minutes. But Brunson has 7 points. Perkins has 5. Fowles has 4. Whalen has 4. That's really good balance and pretty solid contributions from those 4 players. Whitcomb looks works for Carolyn Swartz, who has just checked into the game and made a nice left-handed layup there.
And that's one thing Seattle does so well is their big players cutting to the basket, looking for the ball. Perimeter players doing a great job of getting them the ball where they want it.
Pearson, top of the key. Short off the rim. Howard, offensive rebound. Working for the second chance. Gets another try at it. No basket, they'll say, and it's a travel on Howard.
Oh, that's too bad, because Howard worked so hard for that. You wanted her to get that.
And how, look at the physical contact and how hard Howard worked for this a couple of different times. I didn't see the travel.
Nor did I.
Oh, she, okay, so the ball didn't hit the rim. She caught her own shot. Okay, I thought it was deflected, but there was a lot of traffic underneath it, so that might be the right call after all. I'll dissect that one tonight when I get home. Watch the replay. Perkins, oh, pushes Brianna Stewart. That's going to be an offensive power foul on Glennett Pearson.
Pearson's not happy about that. I think she thinks Stewart flopped on that one.
She's still talking about it. Let's watch Stewart.
Well, there's no doubt Pearson uses her body, uses her shoulder to get positioning.
Maybe not quite to the extent that we saw the reaction, but in any case, it's a foul. It's a foul on Minnesota. Noelle Quinn, the former member of the Lynx, hits the shot, but Pearson ends up on the ground, and there's a foul on Seattle. So all of a sudden, this game went a little haywire. And we're seeing some physical play in the paint. Jenny Busek looks like she's wondering what is going on. Well, look at Swartz pushing Pearson.
Yes, Swartz gives a nice push, and Pearson does what you're supposed to do as you hit the floor and hopes that you'll get the call.
And now the officials are at the table to determine whether or not this foul came before or after the shot. So it's because Noelle Quinn hits this shot here, and then you see almost simultaneously Pearson go to the floor. The call on the court was no basket. Carolyn Swartz just...
That was a pretty good hit.
That was very solid. There was no messing with that play. So they'll get everything straight at the scorer's table. The basket is going to count. Just listening to the PA to make sure I have this correct. So the basket counts by Noelle Quinn. Swords gets charged with a foul. And Pearson is back up. All good. Here we go. A four-point Lynx lead in the final 33 seconds of the first quarter. Montgomery keeps the dribble alive into the paint. Another foul, but it's an and-one. It rolled around on the rim and went in for Renee Montgomery.
And this is one of the areas that I thought the Lynx could really exploit with Seattle is when you attack the basket, make them defend you. That's where they're going to end up fouling you.
It's the first foul on Sammy Whitcomb. And Montgomery just got that body contact, kept her body in good control. And there's the three-point play for Montgomery. Whitcomb, she's guarded by Alexis Jones, the rookie in the game in the first quarter tonight. Three-point shot off the back of the rim, but it'll be a second-chance opportunity for Seattle. Stewart rolls to the basket. High off the glass and hits. What a tough shot for Brianna Stewart.
One of the things she can do that makes her such a special player is her ability to hold on to the ball and take it to the basket.
Well, that was impressive. Two defenders and a pretty hard hit, too. And the adjustment she made to get that ball high up off the glass and give it a chance.
Yep, it was a good read. And
with the left hand, she's right-handed. Montgomery with four on the clock. Gets a three-point shot off. Back of the rim. So it was a little messy as we went along here, the first quarter, look at the championships. Four of them for Stewart, three for Mosqueda Lewis, two for... two for Moore. And Sylvia fouls, gets another two. Sylvia has 6 points in this game tonight. Is waiting for that to update.
Also out of LSU.
If we showed all those
Connecticut
exactly. Friends.
Let's get another school in there.
A great school. And a nice start to the second quarter for Minnesota. A basket from fouls and then forcing Seattle into a turnover. Jewel Lloyd checks back in for the Storm. Whalen back running things at the point. This is the starting five that Minnesota went with tonight. Back on the court. With Lynette Pearson. Four of the five are in. Rebecca Brunson is on the bench.
And I like that look by Pearson right there. She's a nice dump down to Sylvia Falls. And when Sylvia's in the lane like that, she's that deep, you got to get her the ball.
Fouls on Carolyn Swartz. That's the second of Swartz. And Perkins keeps the dribble alive. A nice move to get around Whitcomb. Offensive stolen out of the hands of Fouls by Stewart. Whitcomb around the screen. A little too far for Stewart. Another turnover.
Yeah, turnovers have really plagued this team, Seattle, all season long. One of the reasons why they've struggled on the offensive end of the court is turning the ball over.
That's four for Seattle so far tonight. We'll see if Minnesota can capitalize. So far, the Lynx only have 2 points off of Seattle's four turnovers. Pearson. She's got a nice shot. She really has nice body control, a good rotation on the ball, good arc. She has a nice-looking jump shot, nice-looking three-point shot. Lloyd. Again to Noelle Quinn, and now back to Lloyd. She'll take it from the wing. That is a three. Three-pointer for Jewel Lloyd. She's up to 8 points. She leads all scorers.
Well-needed shot there by Jewel Lloyd, in particular from the three-point line, because that's how Seattle runs their offense.
Lloyd's coming off that big game on Friday night. A travel by Fouls. On Friday night, the Storm scored 109 points and beat Dallas. And Jewel Lloyd had 27 points in that game to tie her season high. Sue Bird is also back in to run the offense for Seattle. But Lloyd is one of those players that she can light up the scoreboard.
Yeah, she's an explosive player, and she's difficult to guard because you have to play her straight up. She can attack the basket, yet as you can see in this game, she can hit that three ball.
And now it is the starting five back in for Minnesota. Whalen too strong on the pass for Fouls. It's the sixth turnover now for Minnesota. Six turnovers, and it's resulted so far in only 2 Seattle points. That's the silver lining to this
exactly.
Kind of sloppy first half.
Definitely slowing up the pace of the game.
Lloyd takes the screen from Swartz. Langhorne, and it's deflected by Fouls. And then a little too much. No, I thought it was going to be a foul call. It's just an out-of-bounds call when Lloyd stepped on the baseline there. So this is Minnesota ball.
Fouls doing what she does best, is making it difficult for people to shoot down low.
That's part of the reason that Minnesota has held opponents to 30 points or fewer in the paint for 5 consecutive games. That foul came before the shot of Moore. And that's going to be 3 fouls now on Carolyn Swartz. 3 fouls in 6 minutes.
And Seattle needs her in this game, in particular when you're battling someone like Sylvia Fowles. She needs someone to put a body on her.
And she's got the height too, 6'6", matching up exactly with Fowles. And now it's Noelle Quinn with the foul. Quinn played for the Lynx in 2007 and 2008. She's been with Seattle now for a handful of years. Moore. Oh, well, how did she keep her balance on that shot? So soft. A Great touch from Maya Moore.
And she just gets a little bit of space away from Quinn and is able to hit that off-balance shot.
Bird trying the no-look pass to get it into Langhorne. Rebecca Brunson got in the middle of that play.
Maya Moore's able to score in so many ways, but what makes this shot so amazing is how quickly she releases that ball.
Makes it pretty hard to defend when that is how quickly things happen. Tipped. Loose ball. Whalen has it. Whalen picked up the dribble. She has Brunson there. They'll swing it around to the other side or attempt to. Now down inside to Fowles. Brunson. Couple of fakes and then the shot and the make. Brunson has 9 points. She's leading Minnesota.
But it starts with a great pass from Sylvia Fowles, who gets double teamed down low, gets the ball back out to Brunson, and the Lynx have so many options.
Stewart on the drive. It's a Minnesota foul, but it looked like two defenders were just standing still. But here's the work between Brunson and Fowles.
And this is something that Fowles has worked on this year, too, just her ability to read the defense, be calm, and get that ball out.
Stewart is at the line. She has drawn 4 fouls already in this game. The Minnesota Timberwolves and Lynx Basketball Academy is accepting registration for its summer camps and clinics. Choose between 2 and 5 day camps for the youth basketball player in your life with locations all around the state. Visit TimberwolvesBasketballAcademy.com to find a camp or clinic near you.
Stewart does a great job of getting to the free throw line. She knows how to use her body.
So she got that foul against Perkins. Look at, again, Brunson. She got herself free and cleared for those 11 points now tonight. To finish this thought, for the third time on Stewart, that foul was on Gia Perkins. Caused, gained, however you want to word it, by Brianna Stewart. She's also drawn 2 on Maya Moore and 1 tonight. Brunson had 12 points on Friday night against Atlanta and 8 rebounds. She went 4 of 8 from the floor. You mentioned that 3-point shot. She's hit one of those tonight. She's 9th in the WNBA in 3-point accuracy, 12th in the league in rebounding. So she's got that mix. Well, she's pretty good at a lot of different things, including getting that board right there.
Absolutely. And when you have a Maya Moore and a Sylvia Fowles, sometimes you don't spend as much time talking about what Brunson brings to this team. But trust me, it's a lot. That's a great lob pass down low.
Brunson fed Fowles. Fowles was then fouled. And that's going to be on Alicia Clark. But you're right, that connection, too. And Brunson, we've talked to her about spacing the floor and how far she gets out on the three-point line, and that's not necessarily something new this year, but how much it helps Sylvia in her game and how much it can help Brunson too now that she's been asked to shoot more threes. It just kind of all flows together.
Right, and that she's willing to make that effort to get better from the three-point line at this point in her career. It's very impressive.
It's the biggest lead for Minnesota tonight. So far, 10 points. We'll see if Sue Bird and the Storm have an answer. Last night, Minnesota had a pretty good lead against Atlanta. Or not last night, Friday night. And then the Dream had a surge before halftime. And cut into that lead pretty significantly. Minnesota, of course, had the answer. Lloyd got it off just before the shot clock buzzer.
That is one thing Seattle is very good at, is using the whole shot clock to get their offensive sets off.
Yeah, Seattle is a very good shooting team. Number 1 in the WNBA at 48%. There's Brunson in that long-range shot we just talked about. So Seattle is first in the league in field goal percentage at 48%. There's another one by Sue Bird. That's a 3 for Bird. She's got 2 of them tonight, 2 for 2 behind the arc. But Seattle doesn't take a lot of shots. Last in the league at 61.5 attempts per game. So they're pretty efficient, though, and right now the lead is down to 5.
Right now.
The Lynx have 18 paint points. Seattle has 6. But Seattle is 3 of 3 in the paint. Minnesota's 9 of 12. So just think about the number of shots. And Sills is going to try to get another one here. Seattle's taken 3 shots in the paint. Minnesota's taken 12. Clark picks up her 2nd foul. Sills will go back to the free throw line. She's 2 of 2 tonight. And 3 of 3 from the floor. So she's not missed yet. 8 rebounds, or 8 points, 3 rebounds. Fouls at 29 and 8 Friday night in Atlanta. Fox Sports North is partnering with Girls on the Run to find responsible, enthusiastic males and females to serve as volunteer coaches. Coaches come from all walks of life. They don't need to be runners. The most important criteria is being a positive role model and demonstrating a dedication to Girls on the Run core values. They are inclusivity, optimism, and gratitude. Learn more at gotrtwincities.org/coach. I will sign you up, Leah. Lloyd hits Clark, and they swing it back out. Bird has plenty of time to get set. Fires a little strong, and the defensive rebound goes to Fouls. Montgomery, nice lob in to Moore. Can't finish twice. Moore tried the tip back, then got it again. And the dish to Fouls, and she can't get it.
That's a lot of work.
You wanted to get the points on that. She has so much finesse around the basket. You're just waiting for the little tip in to go in.
Those were beautiful shot attempts, too. That was a nice-looking drive, too, and a float finish from Alicia Clark. First points of the game, first shot of the game for Clark.
Yeah, Clark has been quiet in this game. She had a big game against the Lynx last time we met up with Seattle.
And there's Fouls. That time she gets one. Fouls up to 11 points. And Alicia Clark averages 8 points per game. Friday night, she had 14 in the win over Dallas. 2 more for Brianna Stewart. And maybe we haven't gushed enough about Stewart because we have high expectations for her already. Only her 2nd WNBA season, and she figured this game out at this level really quickly. Moore, baseline. She's that type of player, too. Maya, is they're just ready for this level.
That's a nice-looking move down low. Frustration by Stewart, but you're right. She's such a finesse player. What she's able to do going up against someone like Sylvia Fouls, I mean, she's a forward.
Oh, it nearly got the steal. Brunson then had it knocked away. Perkins comes away with the loose basketball and had it roll off the rim. Minnesota's had a couple of nice chances late in the 2nd quarter here and has not been able to convert. Stewart, what a pass! No look to Alicia Clark. How did Stewart even see that?
Yeah, and all of a sudden the Lynx just look tired here in the last couple minutes here in this first half. They're totally lost sight of the ball there.
And just like Friday night in Atlanta, the lead has been cut significantly. It's now a 4-point lead for Minnesota. Moore has Fouls posted up. Instead, takes the long two and drains the long two. And there's the timeout. The Lynx will regroup. Back up by 6. Moore has 7 points. And Brianna Stewart has had a couple of nice-looking baskets here as well. She's got 9 points. How about the pass? Oh.
The court sense from that young athlete who's going to be continue to get better and better in this game. Her ability to do so many things in the offseason. They talked about her getting her handle and so she can...
Who has Jewel Lloyd and this up-and-coming talent?
Well, that's why I think everyone is struck by the fact that they've been sitting under 500 all season long just based on having those players along with a Sue Bird kind of leading the way for this team.
Stewart, an awkward turnaround, never got her body kind of set in the right angle. It'll be Minnesota basketball. Stewart has had some struggles from the field. As impressive as she's looked at times, she's 2 of 7. Cutting Maya Moore. Pearson found her, and then the Lynx work it nicely around to Montgomery. That was some nice ball movement.
And I think that's really where the Lynx are at their best, when they're not thinking. They're just moving that ball quickly with confidence.
Bird first half. Bird takes the long three-point try, and that one's off badly. And now all of a sudden, Minnesota looks like it's got some life, and Seattle looks like the tired team. Montgomery works away around the defender, gets a shot up at an awkward angle. Pearson, offensive rebound. It's second chance, but that's also off the rim. Bird will try it again. This time she's set up, lined up, and drains it. Sue Bird is 3 of 5 behind the arc. She's got 9 points.
That is what makes her dangerous. You do have to guard Sue Bird when she's out there. She may look to pass that ball, but she can still hit the three ball.
Bird is the oldest active player in the WNBA at 36 years old. Let's have a handful of 35-year-olds, but Bird takes the title. You would never know it by the way she still plays. Loose ball knocked around. The shot clock went off first. There should be time left on the game clock, though, because the shot clock reached zero, and there's a .4 still on the game clock. The officials reset that quickly. So with .4, Stewart will inbound from the other end of the court. Time will run out. That is the end of the first half in St. Paul. Minnesota led by as many as 10. Seattle made a surge with a couple of minutes left in the second quarter established. That's when they're toughest to beat.
Yeah, I think you're right, and I think it really makes the defense work so hard is when you have to collapse the defense inside to protect the paint, and then you get the ball back out to your perimeter players.
And look at Maya Moore bringing the ball up the court for the first play of the third quarter. And yes, Whalen is in the game. Lindsey Whalen is coming off the screen right there. Lynx just give a little different look. To start the second half here, fouls, turns, can't get it off the roll.
Great look by Maya Moore to her post player. Those two have a great connection on the court.
Stewart now Lloyd. Jewel Lloyd at 10 points to lead Seattle in the first half, and a nice pass there. Stewart got the basket and one.
Beautiful pass.
It's a third foul on Sylvia Fowles.
Nice little pocket pass into Stewart. Stewart has the ability to finish at the basket. Even though she is lean, she has those long arms and a nice touch around the basket.
Points in this game for Brianna Stewart. She scored 20 or more in 9 consecutive. Lynx looking for a little more breathing room in this game. Brunson, that's a 3-point try off the rim. Bird comes away with it. Sue Burbs, 3 of 5 behind the arc. All 3 of her main baskets were threes. Turnover, here comes Minnesota. Whalen, get past her old friend. They've been friends for a long time. They've been national team teammates, Olympians.
Minnesota finally getting some points off the fast break, pushing the ball up and down the court.
That's right, the first fast break points in the game for either team. Odd statistic. Brunson off the feed for Moore.
That's great basketball right there. Starts off with a great dish by Maya Moore.
4 assists for Moore, 13 points for Brunson. Langhorn blocked by Fowles. The second chance and a third try finally from Langhorn. Good persistence there. Crystal Langhorn shoots 67.6%. She's got the highest field goal percentage in the league. That player is the second highest. It's Sylvia Fowles.
They're right down low underneath, so they should have a high percentage, but Langhorn is not that tall, and she really did a nice job going up against 2 defenders.
Bird misses from 3. Crystal Langhorn is only 6'2". So to shoot as she does, 68%. She's second in career field goal percentage to Sylvia Fowles. Her career field goal percentage is 57%. She's shooting 10 percentage points higher than that. But then again, so is Fowles. 9 percentage points higher this season than her career.
I think you have to get used to shooting while you're getting hit and being able to finish.
And that time Langhorn turned it over.
with the travel. This is something that was definitely talked about at halftime, feeding Sylvia Falls more. Those are baskets that the Lynx need to get their offense running.
Seven turnovers for Seattle, seven for Minnesota as well.
Hasn't hurt the Lynx much, though. Seattle's only converted those into 2 points.
Foul on Alicia Clark, trying to swipe the ball away from Moore.
He has a tough duty out there trying to slow Moore down on the defensive end of the court. That's the third foul for Clark. Whalen guarded closely by Jewel Lloyd. Whalen just takes it the entire time. Baseline, tough shot. The rebound, Langhorne. Kristen Langhorne has 7 rebounds. Lloyd gets the shot up, and she'll have a chance at 2 free throws.
Well, that's a great play started by the savvy Sue Bird, who just sees the court so well. I could see that she saw Jewel before Jewel even got to where she was on the court. Jewel just doesn't have the right positioning down low, but knows how to get herself to the free throw line.
Second foul on Perkins. And Lloyd at the free throw line. She scored her 1,000th point this season. That was May 21st, so early on. And is a career 90% free throw shooter. Perkins into the front row and then into the broadcast table, but got it. No harm. Foul on Brianna Stewart on the push there. So Maya Moore will inbound. Whalen again goes to work on Lloyd. Pass was deflected. Perkins has it. Rims out. Look who's there for the rebound. Fouls. She has had some really nice looks. Close opportunities. She does not miss a lot of those.
Yeah, that's frustrating for her. You can see it in her face. She wants to hit those shots down low. Has been doing it all season long.
Lloyd goes into the first row of fans. Here's Perkins pushing the pace. Spins and tried to get it off to Fouls, and it'll be Minnesota ball. Sue Bird was the last to touch it. Carolyn Swartz is checking back into the game. She has 3 fouls in the first half. She'll take the place of Brianna Stewart. Stewart's got 2 fouls. Moore. The push on Clark. No, it's a blocking foul on Alicia Clark. And that's going to be 4 on Clark.
She's frustrated. But again, the duty that she has tonight, trying to slow down Maya Moore. Maya takes it right to her.
And that's tough because you can see Moore's hand kind of going into Clark, and it's just a physical play. It's physical contact.
Yeah, it's pretty easy, no call.
Whalen inside the three-point line. Brunson looked like she and Langhorne had arms hooked. And they'll get Langhorne. Second on Langhorne. Here comes a substitution. It'll be Noelle Quinn. And there goes Clark with 4 fouls. It's also 4 team fouls on Seattle. So the next foul on the Storm will send Minnesota to the free throw line. We got 5.5+ to play in the third quarter. Brunson, a nice touch inside the line. It's a long 2.
And it's the passing ability by Minnesota that makes that play happen. Gia Perkins doing a nice job in this game tonight, distributing the ball.
Brunson's got 15 points. Perkins has 5 assists. Bird to Quinn. Noelle Quinn right off the bench misses the 3. Now Whalen up that screen from Fouls. Brunson just hit one. I'll look for a better option. Oh, and Whalen tried to get it inside to Sill right off her hands. The West, East. I mean, the standings exist, but they don't mean what they used to mean, because it used to be the top four teams in each league went to the playoffs, and now it's just everybody's in the mix, and the top eight teams make the playoffs, which is how we ended up with that fantastic finals between the Lynx and LA, which are two teams in the West, obviously.
Yeah, I like it. I like the one and done in the playoffs. I think it brings a sense of urgency to the teams. You want to be good, you better get out of that. You better get to the first two seats. And I really thought it brought a lot of excitement to the playoffs last year.
Physical contact between Swords and fouls. Fourth foul now on Carolyn Swords. Fouls at the free throw line tonight is 3 of 4. Gets the roll. For the first time in franchise history, the Lynx are getting a new logo. On August 11th, when the Lynx host the LA Sparks, we need our most loyal fans in attendance as we reveal a sneak peek of the Lynx logo for next season. Be sure to get your tickets at lynxbasketball.com. This is one night you will not want to miss. And we'll be there.
Wow,
broadcasting
that's right. We're going to have some new gear then, huh? I think we'll get it.
I'm hoping a hand-delivered courtside.
That's exciting.
You know, the Timberwolves have a new logo, a new merchandise, and people are just anxious to see it and to be able to buy it. Jewel Lloyd with a two-pointer jump shot. Lloyd's up to 14 points. Fouls, a nice move on the paint. And Swords has to be careful because she's got the four fouls. And Syl just took that and used it to her advantage. Back-to-back baskets for Jewel Lloyd.
Yeah, Lloyd is really having a great game. And in particular now, is starting to be a lot more aggressive in her efforts to get to the basket.
It's 20 points in the paint now for Seattle because of those back-to-back baskets. Minnesota still got the advantage, though, with 28. Montgomery's three is long, but still was in the right spot. Got the rebound, then drove to the hoop. And that's Swords. That's number 5. One more foul, and she will be out of the game.
See why Sylvia fouls. So difficult to guard. Swords there just has to play straight up defense and not put a body on her.
Fouls hits again at 18 points, 6 of them from the free throw line. Substitution has Langhorne back in the game for Seattle. Now 19 points for fouls, 7 of 8 from the line, 6 of 9 from the floor. She's also got 8 rebounds. Looks for an opening, guarded closely by Moore. Lloyd behind the back, lost it momentarily, but regained possession. 5 on the shot clock. It'll be Lloyd. 3 straight baskets from Jewel Lloyd.
Yeah, she's definitely feeling it in the zone from outside and in.
Jewel Lloyd's up to 19. Again, an offensive rebound off an air ball, which is not easy to do.
Well, Lynx players just want to thank Sylvia Fouls for cleaning up everything after everyone. If you miss a shot, she's got it. You air ball it, she's got it.
Jewel Lloyd scored 9 consecutive points for Seattle, so it's only fitting she would take a shot there, but missed the shot. Fouls has been the answer for Minnesota, driving into the lane. Any way she can to find room
with a solid double team on her.
It's an 11-point lead for Minnesota that ties the biggest lead of the night. And Lloyd's going to try to keep pumping him in. 3-point attempt is short. Stewart knocked it up momentarily, but Fouls regains possession, and here's Moore bringing it up. Fouls has scored 8 straight for Minnesota, so it's been Lloyd for Seattle, Fouls for Minnesota.
Sylvia Fouls cleaning up off the glass. And look at the defense here. Does a nice job of just splitting the defense, going up strong. You know, and this definitely was the game plan for Minnesota in the second half in particular. As we have
to get inside to Sylvia Falls.
She certainly established her presence well. At halftime, Falls had 11 points. She's got 23 now.
That's 12 points in the second, or in this third quarter, I should say.
They're showing more appreciation for it.
Yeah, deservedly so. Maya Moore hits two free throws. She's been a little bit quiet tonight. 9 points. 3 of 8 shooting. Those were her first free throws. She does have 4 assists and 3 rebounds. Stewart answers with a three-pointer. Brianna Stewart has range. That's her first three-point make on 3 attempts tonight.
Nice looking shot.
Defense gets a little too tight there for Seattle. And that's Noelle Quinn with a second foul. Tuesday, Miguel Sano leads the Twins against Will Myers and the Padres in a game you can only see on FS1. It all starts Tuesday night, 8:30 on FS1, or watch it live on Fox Sports Go. Twins, last I heard, were in extra innings in Oakland. And I don't want to, now I know what happened, and I don't want to talk about it.
All right, then I won't discuss
well,
it with
producer
you.
Our producer, Vanessa Lambert, just informed me what happened, and let's go back to the Lynx here,
got
leading
it
by 11 against Seattle. Quinn and Bird. Nice bounce pass from Bird to Langhorne, but one dribble put it in the hands of Brunson. Now the Lynx have scored on 7 consecutive possessions here in the third quarter. Hoping this leads to number 8, Perkins, for 3. Not 8 consecutive possessions.
Not quite. It's a nice cross-court pass by Pearson. The setup, Gia.
Bird. Quinn, they swing it around. Langhorne with the fake, and then the shovel pass to Stewart. That was a nice display of passing and just good rhythm by Seattle on that offensive possession.
Yeah, and I thought the reason that happened for Seattle like that is Langhorne was really patient and watching the defense, reading it, and reacting.
Moore on the feed from Pearson. Nice pass from Glenette Pearson to find Maya Moore. Pearson's first assist of the game, and she has not scored. But that was pretty impressive.
Maya Moore just showing her just quick finesse move right around the basket, but really just a great read.
Good anticipation, a leading pass, and then Pearson fouled Stewart on the other end here, and that's why Brianna Stewart's at the free throw line. Stewart sitting at 16 points. Brunson will take a seat, so will Maya Moore. Brunson's got 15 points, Moore 12 points. And it's just a good balance of scoring. Different players stepping up for the Lynx, as tends to happen.
A lot of
Brunson.
Yep, a lot of different options for this team.
Pearson, this time it's to Fowles, exactly opposite part of the court. She hit Maya cutting through one way. That time she hit Fowles posting up.
And very patient on the offensive end. That's one thing I've liked about the addition of Pearson on this team is she just is the veteran, the savvy veteran,
yep,
who takes her time.
Yep. And she had gone for the outlet pass, threw that one away. And Pearson had 0 assists in this game. And in the final minute and a half, she picked up 2. Fowles had 14 points in that third quarter. Minnesota leads by 12. 13 points in the quarter. Brianna Stewart brings the ball up and Fowles guards her. Gives it up to Clark. Back to Stewart and back to Clark.
And Seattle's had some players step up in this game, but they really haven't had an answer for Sylvia Fowles.
Stewart tries to be the answer, hits 2 more for 19 points in this game. Yeah, Fowles has 25 points, 10 rebounds, 2 blocks, and she's drawn 7 fouls against Seattle players. Montgomery, she'll take the 3, a little strong. Bird and Stewart, who has the last 8 points. points for Seattle. The bird is inside the line. That would have been a two.
And that's the part of Seattle's game that really is inconsistent, is are they going to hit those big shots, those big inside-outside shots that they need to break open their offense?
Pearson with a nice-looking drive, but just could not finish. Bird to Clark, knocked away. And, you know, Seattle is at 59 points right now. The last game Seattle played was Friday against Dallas. We mentioned the score already. But 109 points Seattle scored and had 60 at halftime of that game. Sammy Whitcomb hits for three. The game that Seattle played before that, the Storm scored a total of 60 points. And that was the loss at L.A., 68-60. Two more for Sylvia Fowles. So Seattle went back-to-back games. 60 points scored. Then the next game, 60 points at halftime for 109 total.
The inconsistency, and that's the thing that makes them so dangerous. And I know that the Lynx were preparing for that today. If this team is on and all five starters get the double figures like they did the other night, you're in trouble.
Montgomery moves it in after three-point tries, a couple of them. That time she drove and went for two off the glass. And the other thing about Seattle is Sammy Whitcomb, who hit a three and then on the last possession missed the three. When she starts rolling and hitting those, this team can score so quickly. She had a game at the end of May against New York where she had 6 3-pointers and 22 points all in the second half. And it tied a WNBA record. But when she does hit them, sometimes it's just bang, bang, bang.
Right, absolutely. And I think that's the difference in those games that we're seeing and why they're having a hard time in a lot of these games is who is stepping up, when are they, and when have they gone cold?
Bird hits the first free throw. Maya Moore is back in the game. Jenny Busek has a word with Sammy Whitcomb. We mentioned her three-point shooting. She's the 39% three-point shooter this season. So you'd like to see that climb a little bit into the 40s. And 39 is not a terrible number by any means. Bird. And on the rebound, Whalen is fouled by Alicia Clark. That's going to be five on Clark. So she's got five. Swords has five. And if either one of those picks up number six, they'll be done. And so far, Clark is still in the game. Now here comes Noelle Quinn. I think Alicia Clark was saying, no, I'm
good, yeah.
No, and Jenny Busek's like, no, you're, nope.
Well, it speaks to the caliber of players that the Minnesota Lynx have, and you know that Clark frustrated there because, I mean, she was going up against Maya Moore for most of the night, and she's difficult to guard.
Perkins had fouls, so fouls had her defender pinned. The pass was just a little bit too far ahead, too much of a lead.
Yeah, it was a really nice seal by Sylvia Fowles. And when your post player takes the time and the effort to get a seal like that, you really want to get him the ball.
Quinn is bringing the ball up on this possession for Seattle. Lloyd and an offensive foul. And that was Crystal Langhorne. I couldn't tell if it came away from the ball or if it was Lloyd coming off that screen there. But it's on Langhorne. And that is her fourth. So Seattle has two players with five fouls and one player with four fouls. Minnesota has nobody in foul trouble. And then they've got Maya Moore.
Just coming alive. She's always been a really, really good player. This year, she's just taken her game to another level. And she gave the credit to Coach Reeve and her coaching staff as far as being able to pull it out of her, get her in a situation where she could play at a higher level game in and game out.
Still had 29-8 Friday night in Atlanta. Her high for the season is 30, and she's sitting at 27 right now. Whalen picks up a foul there. That's just the first on Lindsay.
It's an old friend. Back Sue Bird to the floor, and then right away goes to get her back up.
And you don't mean old in number. Right. We've right. been through that.
Plus, they're both younger than me, so.
And that's a matchup we looked at, too, at the beginning of our broadcast. In two of the very best point guards we've ever seen play the game, two of the best ambassadors for the game, two of the best teammates. Just all around positive things to say about Waylon and Bird.
Yeah,
numbers two and three all time in the WNBA in assists.
It has been really fun and amazing watching them both play over the years. And Lindsey Whalen up close, because we've seen her so much. Her game's different than Sue Bird's, but they both really represent the league so well.
And this season is, the numbers for Whalen are a little bit down because minutes are down, but her effectiveness is still there. We mentioned the assists, steals, just accomplishments. When you play that long, you accomplish a lot. And Sue Bird is in her 16th season. Lindsey Whalen's in her 14th season. Sue Bird is 36 years old. She'll be 37 on October 16th.
Yeah, it's impressive to be able to play this game for that long. Sue Bird looks great. She looks like she's in great shape. She's still running her team, has a lot of respect throughout the WNBA and the world. Lindsey Whalen, the same here in Minnesota. She's kind of the queen bee here in Minnesota.
Jewel Lloyd hits again and still is Seattle's leading scorer. 22 points for Lloyd. Stewart has 19. Bird has 10, and those are the three players in double figures for Seattle. Whalen, that's a three-point try off the front of the rim. And Alicia Clark skies in for the rebound with five fouls. Lloyd missed that time. Jewel Lloyd's put up 18 shots in this game, made eight of them. Whalen's gonna set things up again. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Lob inside, Fowles just went and got that ball. 29 points for Sylvia Fowles.
That is a great lob inside. That's not an easy pass to make.
Season high, 7 assists from Gia Perkins, who made that pass. Langhorne answers on the other end. Perkins has played a great game. 33 minutes she's played, 5 points in the first quarter. 5 for the game, 7 assists. She's in the starting lineup because Simone Augustus is not here, not with the team tonight for personal reasons. Maya Moore gets called for the foul.
And you feel comfortable making this pass as a guard because you know who's going to catch it. You know Sylvia Fowles, even if you get close to the area, is going to be able to grab it.
And there's Perkins taking a break. Lloyd, cross-court pass. Brianna Stewart just plows into Brunson. And look at the reaction from Rebecca. Two fists in the air, even though she was flat on her back.
Gave up the body, and it was worth it.
Look at the contact here.
Yeah, Stewart goes in hard. Drops her shoulders. Most difficult call to make in basketball.
And they were both moving to the same spot. But that is an offensive foul called on Brianna Stewart. And so could not quite corral that one. Third foul on Stewart, by the way. And here comes Swords with 5 fouls. She and Alicia Clark both have 5 and are both on the court. And that was a quick rest for Perkins. She'll be checking in at the next dead ball. Minnesota's done a nice job in this game of converting off of turnovers, because each team has 11 turnovers. Identical, 11 turnovers. Lloyd, jump shot is good. Jewel Lloyd, 24 points. The difference is Minnesota has converted those turnovers to 11 points. Seattle's only made Minnesota pay with 4 points.
And when you play a team like Minnesota, you have to take advantage of any points you can get, in particular up 11 turnovers.
Three-pointer, Rebecca Brunson. Her second of the night. 18 points and a celebration from the bench.
She has looked fantastic this evening.
Stewart answers with 3. Stewart's got 22. Seattle's hit 9 of 22 from 3. Minnesota's 5 of 15. Moore hangs in the air and goes off the glass. What a move. What a basket from Maya. And that time Stewart's answer rattled out. Go back and forth here. An 11-point lead for the Lynx. It's kind of been steady like that. Seattle hasn't been able to close the gap, but Minnesota hasn't been able to stretch it out either.
Yeah, that's right. And you kind of feel like, wow, Seattle could come up with a little more scoring, a little more offense consistently.
Moore reached in there and commits her fourth foul.
Look at the drive. She uses her body so well. She's such a finesse player that it makes her really difficult to defend. You're not sure where she's going to go with the ball.
Timeout on the court with Minnesota leading Seattle by 11.
Lynx are trying to get great passes from perimeter plays. They've worked hard and have been dominant.
Still had that big third quarter with 14 points. She's got 29 for the game. Season high is 30. Clark lobbed to Swords. And she missed the shot. Those players are both, again, playing with 5 fouls. Perkins. And here's Moore. One dribble and an awkward-looking shot, but a pretty nice finish.
Maya Moore hits a lot of shots when she's being contested, and that was one of them. One of those shots where she was not open. Still hits a big shot.
Lloyd, quick three-pointer. I mean, this just didn't look good until it went through the net.
And Clark's playing defense as best she can. She's got long arms. She's in front of her. And Maya still manages to score on her.
And part of that might have been Maya just going at Alicia Clark, trying to get her her 6th foul, get her out of the game.
And Maya uses her body really well to score on people to get to the free throw line.
Stewart tried to pick up that loose ball and head the other way, and she fell out of bounds. And I couldn't see the traffic over there if she was pushed or just tripped, but it is Minnesota basketball. Moore. Dishes to Brunson. Beautifully assist Moore. Bucket Brunson.
Does a good job of getting away from the defense, so she's able to get the nice pass off.
6 assists for Moore. Brunson has 20 points. The lead is up to 15, which is the biggest of the night for Minnesota. And it's a whistle on Sylvia for her 4th foul tonight. So here's Stewart, 22 points. It's 2 over her average for the season. Join Fox Sports North and the Minnesota Lynx for the Run, Walk, and Roar 5K on Saturday, August 12th at Veterans Memorial Park in Richfield. Meet Lynx players, receive a free t-shirt and a lower-level ticket to a 2017 regular season home game. Visit foxsportsnorth.com/events for details. Minnesota's just trying to have a clean finish to close the game. And Maya Moore is looking for a spectacular one.
I like the recognition. Looking to the fans. A little smile there.
Big smile from Moore. 22 points. And then a near steal. Moore is just all of a sudden caught fire offensively, defensively. She's full of life.
She is all over the place. And that is what she brings to this game. She's not going to stop working hard until that buzzer goes off.
Lloyd to Stewart. And Lloyd is free for a three-pointer. But can't hit it. Langhorne gets the rebound and the easy deuce off the glass.
Quiet night for Langhorne.
Yeah, Crystal Langhorne, after that basket, now has 8 points. She averages 13. And she is the best shooter, field goal percentage-wise, in the WNBA. But she's only taken 6 shots tonight, 4 of 6. Maya Moore has a chance to add to her total. She has 10 points in the fourth quarter alone for 22 so far. And that is the 6th foul on Alicia Clark, so she's out.
She played for a while with those 5.
Yeah, she sure did. And she's a great player, very strong, nice finesse player. And she had a tough matchup tonight.
And Moore at the free throw line is 4 of 5 tonight. The Lynx play home against Atlanta. They play Atlanta 3 times, actually, in the span of 5 games, and then a couple of games on the road. One of them, Atlanta, Indiana game on Fox Sports North Dallas. Seattle starts a 5-game road trip tonight. It doesn't have them back in Seattle until August 13th. Lloyd scores again. Jewel Lloyd has 26 points. Here's the road trip for Seattle. After this game here at Minnesota, then it's at Dallas, at San Antonio, Connecticut, and Phoenix. So from San Antonio to Connecticut, back to Phoenix, and then back to Seattle.
Those are big, big games for them.
Noelle Quinn hits a 3-pointer. But we're down to the final nitty-gritty here in St. Paul. With this win tonight, Minnesota officially clinches a spot in the postseason. It's an 11-point win over Seattle, where the Lynx never really pulled away but never really let Seattle back into it. 19-2 is the record now, and it only builds on what is already the best start in Minnesota Lynx franchise history. A nice, solid win from Xcel Energy Center. Sylvia Fowles had 29 points and 12 rebounds, and she will join us when we return here to St. Paul. Games in Lynx history. Seattle is 10-12 and in the postseason playoff mix right now. Seattle starting 5 has been the same since the 3rd game of the season. And Sue Bird, Jewel Lloyd, Alicia Clark, Brianna Stewart, and Crystal Langhorn. Stewart and Lloyd were consecutive rookies of the year in each of the last 2 years. The Lynx have their first starting lineup change of this season. Simone Augustus is not with the team tonight for personal reasons, so Gia Perkins will start in her absence with Waylon Moore, Brunson, and Fowles. Leah, what are your keys for tonight?
All right, well, we'll kick it off with the Storm. Value the possession. They have the highest turnover percentage in the league in sharing the ball. They had 29 assists in the win against Dallas. For Minnesota, defensive intensity and attacking the basket. The Storm will struggle defending the Lynx if they're aggressive at getting to the basket.
I'm going to guess Sylvia Fowles is not going to win this tip, or I should maybe say the Lynx will not win this tip. And it goes to Seattle and Sue Bird. Minnesota's not won a tip all season long, and it is by design. Jewel Lloyd puts up the first shot of the game and misses. There's an interesting article in the Star Tribune this morning. It had never really occurred to me that Minnesota never wins the tip. 0 for 20 this season. No tips won last year. This way they get the ball to start the second and third quarter, and that's more important. So it's strategy.
Yes, and something that Coach Reeve has decided is very important to her team, and it sounds like she has a lot of other things that they wouldn't give up in the story that she likes to do as well.
Lindsey Whalen from the elbow hits the first shot of the night for Minnesota. Sue Bird with the ball, 16th season in the WNBA, gives it up to Lloyd. Off the rim for Jewel. She was the rookie of the year in 2015. Brianna Stewart was the rookie of the year last season. So it's a nice mix of youth and veterans on this Seattle team. Whalen misses that time from the left side. Alicia Clark. And now Bird. Into Brianna Stewart, and Stewart goes with the hook shot, a little short. Offensive rebound nicely, though, by Lloyd.
something that Seattle doesn't do very often, second chance points, but the Lloyd does a nice job of getting the offensive rebound.
Perkins into the starting lineup for the first time this season. Dishes to Maya from the corner, in and out. Morris really shot the ball well over the last three games at 55%. Struggled to find her range in the first month of the season. Taps that one away, but it'll stay Seattle ball. Jenny Busek is in her third season as head coach of Seattle. She's been a part of the WNBA, though, for 18 seasons, and she's just trying to get her team over that 500 mark. They've kind of hovered there all season long. They're definitely in the playoff mix, though, at 10-12. Right now, sitting ninth.
And this is a team that has such a great starting five.
Langhorne to Stewart.
You have a couple of all-stars on this team, some of the young up-and-coming players in this league, so you get the sense that when this team starts playing really well together, when they start finishing games, they're going to be something to contend with, but they're going to have to get going pretty quick here.
First foul of the night on Maya Moore. And here is Stewart, the fastest player in the WNBA ever to 1,000 points and 500 rebounds. It took her 55 games. That just happened on Friday, too.
She is something special to watch. She can do so many things with the basketball.
Stewart, a second-year player out of UConn. It's a UConn-heavy game tonight.
Aren't they all?
They tend to be. Perkins out of Texas Tech. Tamaya, UConn product, knocked away. Maya regains control. Perkins looks at the three. Hits the three. Gia Perkins, who's only 23% beyond the arc, hits.
That's a big shot for Gia Perkins getting into the starting lineup. Wants to come in right away. Hit a big shot for Coach Reed.
Bird, top of the key. Long three-pointer. And she nailed that one.
This is the one of the things that makes Seattle difficult to guard because they hit the three ball very well.
Brunson will try to match it. And she gets it. The three balls are just raining in St. Paul.
Talk about it in each and every game, but Brunson's ability to hit that three-point shot, something she worked on in the offseason, paying off for the Lynx now.
Storm swinging all the way around. Here's Clark, puts it on the ground. Bird off the screen, back to Clark. And in the paint, she was looking for Langhorne, but did not find her. It's a turnover for Seattle.
And it's really good to see Gia Perkins hit this big shot early for Minnesota.
Perkins did not score Friday against Atlanta, on 0 of 3 from the floor. Nealon working her way into the paint, turns, it hits. Lindsay's got a couple of baskets already here in this first quarter. Stewart and Berg back and forth. Langhorne, left-handed shot from the baseline is good. Crystal Langhorne is an impressive big player for Seattle who doesn't have a really big like a Sylvia Fowles at 6'6". Brianna Stewart, 6'4", but she plays so much like a forward. And there goes Syl to work on those bigs of Seattle.
First time Minnesota gets to Sylvia Fowles in this game tonight. And that's something you're going to want to see him do over and over in this game. Exploit the paint.
Lloyd. Pounded by Brunson. Nice touch pass by Stewart to Clark, but she couldn't handle. And Moore comes away.
And the Lynx defense, something they worked on in shoot-around today, really doing a nice job of switching and moving on Seattle.
The hook rattles in and out. Stewart grabs the rebound and pushes it up the court, crosses over into the lane. And Stewart made contact with Moore. Foul came on Moore. That is the second. So Moore has two fouls early on in that game. It looked like she was kind of the one that Stewart ran into as opposed to Moore running into Stewart or causing the contact. Lloyd makes it hurt, though. Hits off the jumper.
Let's see how long Coach Green leaves Maya Moore in this game. She's going to pull her out now.
And Renee Montgomery is already at the scorer's table. And there's a first foul on Brianna Stewart. Here's a look at that foul. Or look at the Jewel Lloyd jump shot.
The young and up-and-coming stars, and I guess not really so much up-and-coming anymore. She's been, her third season has been outstanding, but getting better and better every season.
Brunson works on Langhorne off the glass and in. Rebecca Brunson, 2 for 3 with 5 points. Seattle is starting a 5-game road trip tonight. Lloyd drives, and it's another foul on Minnesota. Seattle's playing physical, getting into the bodies, coach, along with Shelly Patterson and James Wade. Walt Hopkins, the whole coaching staff, represented coaching the West. Minnesota just had a heavy presence, and Sylvia Fowles saying that we knew Maya was going to win MVP because she said before the game she wanted to win the MVP.
Oh, well,
so.
Of course, right. Well, it looked like it was a fun time had by all, and I think that is a special event for all of those players to be involved in, and the coaches and the coaching staff to be around all the different players. So it's definitely a really exciting time for the Minnesota Lynx when you have that many representatives.
Whaling was the only starter not part of the All-Star festivities, but she got the rest. And I think at this point, that is pretty valuable. And so is the play of Sylvia Fowles. Offensive rebound up and off the glass. That's 4 straight field goals for the Lynx that have come in the paint.
And something, as we talked about at the top of the broadcast, that will be very important for them. They want to win the battle in the paint tonight.
Clark. Knocked away by Montgomery. That's something we talked about at the beginning of our broadcast, was how well Minnesota has had an advantage in the paint. Part of it is denying your opponent. Part of it is getting points like this.
Absolutely, and having Sylvia Fowles underneath at 6'6", being able to grab offensive rebounds and make easy baskets. 8 points in the paint for Minnesota as compared to Seattle's 2.
Stewart got the shot off just before the shot clock buzzer, but it was off the mark. Whalen brings it up the other way. Crosses over, picks up Langhorne, and now Clark defensively. Knocked away momentarily. Stewart got a hand on it and caused the travel on Sylvia Fowles. So Brianna Stewart, the second-year player, getting up in the grill of Sylvia Fowles.
Yeah, she wants to make Fowles put that ball on the floor just how she did right there and hopes that she'll turn it over.
Seattle substitution is Sammy Whitcomb, who is a 3-point shooting specialist. Lloyd. Brunson skies for the rebound. Renee Montgomery. Foul away from the ball. Judging from the reaction, I'm going to say that's against the Storm. It is. It's Crystal Langhorne. That's her first foul tonight.
Crystal Langhorne, a player that the Lynx really have focused on in this game because of her ability to do so much down low. And she's only 6'2", but she can get a lot done.
She's a heck of a shooter. 68%. Whalen spins free. Nice move by Whalen, but could not finish. Bird dribbles around a couple of defenders. Nice lob for Stewart. They swing it around. There's Whitcomb. And after the ball hit a couple of Lynx hands, it ends up in the hands of Gia Perkins. Double team. She finds Fowles, but it's off her hand. So a couple of nice defensive possessions for Seattle.
Well, and both teams on the offensive end, just a little bit thrown by the defense on each side. Both teams kind of lifted the level of the defensive intensity.
And Whalen checks out. Natasha Howard is in the game for Minnesota. Howard has seen a few more minutes. Had a nice game in Atlanta on Friday with 11 minutes and 15 seconds. She had 8 points on 4 of 5 shooting from the field. Bird off the dribble. No call and no basket.
Sue Bird definitely wanted a basket or a call there.
She gave the officials that look, raised her arms. Brunson gets free, gets behind the defender, and lays it in off the glass. Brunson has 7 points to lead Minnesota in scoring. Stewart with the three. Fouls her third rebound.
Seattle really gone cold from outside, and that's such a huge part of their game.
1 for 5 for the Storm. Perkins, though, she hits, and Gia Perkins is 2 for 2. It's an 8-1 Minnesota run, and Jenny Busek calls a quick timeout to talk about it with her team. Suddenly, it's an 8-point Lynx lead. Rebecca Brunson was part of this surge lead,
doing the dirty work down low. Nice basket, two players on her, and Gia Perkins has been big in this game, coming in as a starter, hitting some nice big open shots for the Lynx.
Perkins is 2 of 2 with 5 points, and again, she started tonight for Simone Augustus, who is not with the team because of personal reasons. And the Lynx actually went on this 8-1 run, Leah, when Maya Moore sat out with her 2 fouls. And that would be the one thing you thought probably wouldn't happen, that the Lynx would just try to maintain, and instead they surged.
Well, I will say the one thing about this Minnesota Lynx team is that they have so many offensive weapons that when Maya Moore goes to the bench, there are so many other players that can score that ball. Now, you probably don't ever want Maya Moore on the bench for that long, but as you said, the team doesn't take a dip when she takes that seat.
And she picked up the 2 early fouls, and so to be able to sub her out and know that your team will be okay for a few minutes, yeah, it is a big deal. Moore didn't score. She only took 1 shot and played 5 minutes. But Brunson has 7 points. Perkins has 5. Fowles has 4. Whalen has 4. That's really good balance and pretty solid contributions from those 4 players. Whitcomb looks for Carolyn Swartz, who is just checked into the game and made a nice left-handed layup there.
And that's one thing Seattle does so well, is their big players cutting to the basket, looking for the ball. Perimeter players doing a great job of getting them the ball where they want it.
But Pearson, top of the key. Short off the rim. Howard, offensive rebound. Working for the second chance. Gets another try at it. No basket, they'll say. And it's a travel on Howard.
Oh, that's too bad, because Howard works so hard for that. You wanted her to get that.
And how, look at the physical contact and how hard Howard worked for this a couple of different times. I didn't see the travel.
Nor did I.
Oh, she, okay, so the ball didn't hit the rim. She caught her own shot. Okay, I thought it was deflected, but there was a lot of traffic underneath, and so that might be the right call after all. I'll dissect that one tonight when I get home.
Watch perfect.
Perkins, oh, pushes Brianna Stewart. That's going to be an offensive power foul on Glennett Pearson.
Pearson's not happy about that. I think she thinks Stewart flopped on that one.
She's still talking about it. Let's watch Stewart.
Well, there's no doubt Pearson uses her body, uses her shoulder to get positioning.
Maybe not quite to the extent that we saw the reaction, but in any case, it's a foul. It's a foul on Minnesota. Noelle Quinn, the former member of the Lynx, hits the shot, but Pearson ends up on the ground, and there's a foul on Seattle. So all of a sudden, this game went a little haywire. And we're seeing some physical play in the paint. Jenny Busek looks like she's wondering what is going on. Well, look at Swartz pushing Pearson.
Yes, yeah, Swartz gives a nice push, and Pearson does what you're supposed to do, is you hit the floor and hopes that you'll get the call.
And now the officials are at the table to determine whether or not this foul came before or after the shot. Because Noel Quinn hits this shot here, and then you see almost simultaneously Pearson go to the floor. The call on the court was no basket. Carolyn Swartz just...
That was a pretty good hit.
That was very solid. There was no messing with that play. So they'll get everything straight at the scorer's table. The basket is going to count. Just listening to the PA to make sure I have this correct. So the basket counts by Noel Quinn. Swords gets charged with a foul. And Pearson is back up. All good. Here we go. A four-point Lynx lead in the final 33 seconds of the first quarter. Montgomery keeps the dribble alive into the paint. Another foul, but it's an and-one. It rolled around on the rim and went in for Renee Montgomery.
And this is one of the areas that I thought the Lynx could really exploit with Seattle is when you attack the basket, make them defend you. That's where they're going to end up fouling you.
It's the first foul on Sammy Whitcomb. And Montgomery just got that body contact, kept her body in good control. And there's the three-point play for Montgomery. Whitcomb, she's guarded by Alexis Jones, the rookie in the game in the first quarter tonight. Three-point shot off the back of the rim, but it'll be a second-chance opportunity for Seattle. Stewart rolls to the basket. High off the glass and hits. What a tough shot for Brianna Stewart.
One of the things she can do that makes her such a special player is her ability to hold on to the ball and take it to the basket.
Well, that was impressive. Two defenders and a pretty hard hit, too. And the adjustment she made to get that ball high up off the glass and give it a chance.
Yep, it was a good read. And good
with the left hand. She's right-handed. Montgomery with four on the clock. Gets a three-point shot off. Back of the rim. So it was a little messy as we went along here. The first quarter. Look at the championships. Four of them for Stewart. Three for Mosqueda Lewis. Two for... And Sylvia fouls, gets another two. Sylvia has 6 points in this game tonight. Is waiting for that to update. Also out of LSU, let me say, if we showed all those
Connecticut
exactly. Kids.
Let's get another school in there.
A great school.
And a nice start to the second quarter for Minnesota. A basket from fouls and then forcing Seattle into a turnover. Jewel Lloyd checks back in for the Storm. Whalen back running things at the point. This is the starting five that Minnesota went with tonight. Back on the court. With Plinette Pearson. Four of the five are in. Rebecca Brunson is on the bench.
And I like that look by Pearson right there. She's a nice dump down to Sylvia Falls. And when Sylvia's in the lane like that, she's that deep. You got to get her the ball.
Fouls on Carolyn Swartz. That's the second of Swartz. And Perkins keeps the dribble alive. A nice move to get around Whitcomb. Offensive stolen out of the hands of Fouls by Stewart. Whitcomb around the screen. A little too far for Stewart. Another turnover.
Yeah, turnovers have really plagued this team, Seattle, all season long. One of the reasons why they've struggled on the offensive end of the court is turning the ball over.
That's four for Seattle so far tonight. We'll see if Minnesota can capitalize. So far, the Lynx only have 2 points.